I'm Meredith Sowers. I run cross country and track for Webster University. In cross country, I just do the 5K and the 6K. In track, I run the 800, the 400 hurdles, the 100 meter hurdles, the 4x4, and I pole vault. There's definitely a difference between the feeling of distance running and sprinting. Like, the feeling you get from distance running is just like you and yourself. Like, you have a lot of time with you and your thoughts and a lot of reflection. I kind of meditate, honestly, when I run for long periods of time because I don't listen to music. I just me and the road. And then sprinting, it gives you more kind of a runner's high, or you get in this really like euphoric state after you do a sprint and you do it well, and it's just like adrenaline is running through your body, and it's one of the greatest feelings I've ever experienced. The beginning of the season, I came off like the best training I've ever had in a summer. I was like in the best shape I've ever been, and then we had a 5K time trial and a 10-mile run the next day, and then my knee started hurting super bad. I've never had that bad a knee pain before, even though I've always struggled with knee issues. And then I went to the doctor and they said that I had like a pretty severe stage of arthritis in both of my knees and that it wasn't going to get better and I should probably just stop running.
It was really hard for her to go to the doctor. The doctor kind of tell her, you know, the x-rays are showing basically that you're not meant to be a runner. So that I think that was really hard for her to bounce back from. But at her core, she's a competitor. She's someone that loves to train at a high level. And she's someone that's always there for her teammates. So I don't think it ever even really crossed her mind that she was gonna quit.
After I finally got all the swelling and the inflammation down in my knees from swimming for like the first half of the season, we found out like this to how to patellarly tape my knees into place so they track right. There's like a gauze pad that you put down and then you rub tape over it, run tape over it, and you shove your kneecaps into like alignment on your knees in the middle. And then you wrap tape all the way around your knee so it stays on through the sweat. And it kind of rubs the back of your legs raw after a while. This injury definitely put into perspective that I can't take things for granted. Like, I figured I was just gonna come into this season and train really hard and have a good chance at nationals. And I never thought an injury was gonna happen or I would have to train through something like that. So it's definitely taught me a lot of humility, and it's taught me a lot of gratefulness, because there's a lot of people out there that can't run because they have like the same injuries as me or like worse injuries than I have. So it's just taught me to be grateful for every day that I do have to run. Well, there's a Bible verse that says everything you do, do it as if you're doing it for the Lord. So I try to take that into like my schoolwork, my social life, my athletics. So I just treat like everything, like as I'm competing, I want to like people to see him through me, like he gave me this ability and I want to do it the best that I can with what he gave me. So it's worth it to me because, like I said, I'm really intrinsically motivated. I'm very internally driven, and running is something that gives me satisfaction, like knowing I can like say I did my best and I worked my hardest, like no matter the scholarship, no matter like what the coaches say or no matter how well I perform. It's like kind of making myself proud of myself, if that makes sense. I guess what I hope to gain from all of this is perseverance. I think like whenever I first got diagnosed with this injury and with this, I thought everything was falling apart. I thought like, wow, I'm done, like this is over. And Coach Graber told me, you know, like through trials, like the greatest athletes come from like the hardest trials because they persevered through it and they know where they were to where they are now. And they're grateful for that process. I think I'm just really looking forward to looking back on this injury and like, wow, like I made it through that and I'm a stronger person because of it, not just in athletics, but in everything else. If I come up with another trial in life, I'll be like, I was told I couldn't run anymore and I still ran through all of that. So if I'm told I can't do this, I'm gonna show you that I can. Your biggest disability is you. Your biggest disability is your own mind, because if you put your mind to it, you can get it done. No matter what people tell you, no matter what your parents tell you, your coaches, or even what a doctor tells you, like they can't stop you if you really want to do something. So like your biggest limitation is yourself.